Lucius Malfoy was the Death Eater right in Voldemort's inner circle, and one of his most trusted ones. He made an appearance in almost all Harry Potter books, but still his earlier life remains a bit unknown. But don't worry, in this video I'm gonna cover his entire life, starting with his birth, his childhood, and all the way to his fate after the war. Lucius Malfoy was born to Abraxas Malfoy in the year 1954 into a very old, wealthy and gentry Weasley family, and raised in the lap of luxury at the family estate, a magnificent house which have been in his family possession for many centuries. Around 1965, at the age of 11, he began attending Hogwarts School of Witchcraft in Weasley and was sorted into Slytherin House, where numerous like-minded young idealists are also often found. During his school career, his skills and potions even earned him the recognition of the school's potion master, Professor Horace Slughorn, the head of Slytherin House, who had him join his slug club of promising students. At some point in his third year at the school, Lucius' father became suspected of having had a hand in the premature retirement of Noble Leech, the first Muggle-born Minister of Magic to ever hold office due to a sudden and mysterious illness which had befallen him. In his fifth year, Lucius was made a prefect, which showed the hard work he put into appearing a modest student in the eyes of his teachers. In 1971, he warmly welcomed Severus Snape into the fold after the Sorting Hat put him in Slytherin, and he would later become close friends. Lucius graduated from Hogwarts around 1972, but being independently wealthy, had no need to seek employment. At some point, he married Narcissa Black. Their son and only child Draco was born in 1918. Lucius became one of Voldemort's Death Eaters and helped wage the First Weasley War in an attempt to bring down the Ministry of Magic. Some of his activities might have included taking the lead in the Thwarting of Muggles. It might have been around this time that Lucius was entrusted the Dark Lord's old school diary, which he was told that it was bewitched, so that whenever he moves to Hogwarts Castle, it would reopen the legendary Chamber of Secrets and send the basilisks living inside to finish Salazar Slytherin's noble work of cleansing the school of all Muggle-born students. We love Voldemort's mark the Potters for death, his intended killing cursor rebounded back at himself and destroyed his body, leaving his army shocked and distraught. After that, the Order of Phoenix and the Ministry of Magic rounded up many of his followers. Eventually, Lucius himself was caught and put on trial before a full wizened government for his involvement in Death Eaters' activities and support of Lord Voldemort's controlling time. Lucius pleaded his innocence and claimed that he had been acting under the Imperius curse, while he was able to avoid the fate of many of his former Death Eaters, most of which was sent to a lifelong detention in the Weasley prison of Azkaban. Some people like Arthur Weasley never believed his version of events and felt Lucius was in Voldemort's inner circle. They were some of the first to come back to our side after you know who disappeared. Said they've been bewitched. My dad doesn't believe it. He says Malfoy's father didn't need an excuse to go over to the dark side. After that, Lucius lived a rather good life with his family, wealthy and therefore without any need to work. He was more than happy with settled life, making himself busy with upholding his influence in the Ministry of Magic. Lucius did not search for Voldemort after his sudden disappearance, believing him to have died that night in Godric's Hollow. Lucius was still associated with his former Death Eaters, who like him avoided Azkaban, many of which became close friends of the family. Indeed, he even remained in touch with Igor Kakarov, who had won his freedom after captured by Kowal, putting a numerous amount of his former fellows into Azkaban in his place. The greatest evidence for his initial careless and taking a look back at his past and lack of faith in the Dark Lord himself was how Lucius discredited Remus of Lord Voldemort's survival as wishful thinking, and instead took interest in probably allying himself with the very person who had brought about their foremost master's downfall. He even looked comfortable in the thought that he one day might get a second chance of world domination if Harry Potter grew up to become another and greater pureblood champion. As the time of Draco's magical education grew even closer, Lucius informed his wife that it was his wish for their son to attend Drumstick Institute, where Kakarov was now headmaster. The school did not allow Muggle-borns to attend, and it was also argued that Drumstick took a far more sensible line about the dark arts than Hogwarts, which was still headed by Albus Dumbledore. His wife, on the other hand, did not like the idea of Draco going to school so far away, thus they decided that he would go to Hogwarts after all. It was probably with the hopes of influencing the day-to-day running of Hogwarts as much as possible and undermine Dumbledore's authority, which led him to join the Hogwarts Board of Governors. As a governor, Lucius submitted a demand to the headmaster to have the Fountain of Fear Fountain banned from the Hogwarts library, as it shows a love between a witch and a muggle. Malfoy claimed that he did not want that. "I do not wish my son to be influenced into selling the purity of his bloodline by reading stories that promote wizard-muggle marriage." This marks the beginning of Malfoy's long attack to have Dumbledore removed from the post of headmaster of Hogwarts. In 1992, during his son's return home from his first year at Hogwarts, Lucius was informed of Harry Potter's refusal of Draco's offer for friendship in favor of his loyalties to the Weasley through their youngest Ron. Despite his disappointment that the wide hopes of the ex-Death Eaters that Harry was another and better Voldemort were completely unfounded, he nevertheless discouraged Draco from seeming too excited about the Potter boy, as Draco spent a lot of his time away from Hogwarts talking badly for Harry and is being placed on the Quidditch team as a first year. Over the summer, Arthur Weasley began conducting raids on several Weasley households to catch any dark or illegal objects under his recently proposed Muggle Protection Act. Before his home could be raided, Lucius sold several of his more possessions at Borgin and Burks and set in motion the old task that Voldemort assigned him, which involved reopening the Chamber of Secrets. Although his master failed before the plan came to happen, Lucius still had Tom Riddle's diary in his possession, therefore he could still make an excellent use of it by purging Hogwarts of Muggleborns, also by destroying Weasley's reputation, and hopefully even having Dumbledore removed from his position at the school. Lucius slipped the diary into Ginny's school books after meeting with the Weasley at Foolish and Blow just before the start of the school term. "Hey girl, take your book, it's the best your father can give you." Only the Malfoy's house elf Dobby was aware of the diary's true nature, but Lucius did not believe his servant would interfere since house elves were unable to refuse the comments of their masters. Dobby took this to his advantage by attempting to warn Harry Potter against returning to Hogwarts. Early this school year, Lucius bought the whole Slytherin Quidditch team, Nimbus 2001, Broomsticks. As Draco was made the team's seeker, he was present at the march that day where Harry was being chased by a bludger, which was cursed by Dobby. Students, animal, and ghosts were petrified by the basilisk that Ginny released as the diary's control on her became stronger. Lucius used the Turbo Resolve to influence the school's board of governors to discredit and vote to dismiss Albus Dumbledore as headmaster for his poor governance of the school. "I'm afraid we feel you're losing your touch. How many attacks have there been now? The more this afternoon, wasn't it? At this rate, there will be no Muggleborns left at Hogwarts, and we all know what an awful loss that would be to the school." Harry fell out to save Ginny and killed the basilisk with Godric's Gryffindor sword. He then destroyed the diary with a basilisk fang, which, though he did not know it was a Horcrux at the time, also destroyed the piece of Voldemort's soul inside. Harry proved Ginny's innocence and pointed an accusing finger at the true criminal, Lucius. However, Dumbledore wanted Lucius to not steal any more of Voldemort's school things, as Arthur Weasley would likely trace them back to him. After that, Harry, in favor to Dobby, managed to trick Lucius and to setting Dobby free. He did this by wrapping the diary in his own sock before handing it back to Lucius. Dobby then caught the sock after Lucius carelessly threw it aside. Therefore, he was no longer forced onto the servitude of the Malfoy family. In a fit of rage upon both losing his servant and being tricked by Harry, Lucius lost his normally control and tried to attack Harry. "You've lost me my servant, boy." However, he was stopped by Dobby, who blasted him down a flight of steps. Lucius had no choice at the moment but to leave. While his role in the opening of Chamber of Secrets could not be successfully proven, Lucius was ultimately stripped of his title as a Hogwarts school governor for treats against his 11 other colleagues. During the year 1994, Lucius' son Draco was attacked by the Hippogriff named Pagpig during a Care of Magical Creatures class. Lucius took the case to the Ministry of Magic's Committee of Disposal of Dangerous Creatures and insisted that the Hippogriff be put to death. Pagpig's owner, gamekeeper Rupius Hagrid, hardly tried to defend him, with the assistance of Hermione Granger, arguing that Pagpig have been provoked by Draco and had attacked in self-defense. Despite his actions, Malfoy still won the case and Pagpig was sentenced to death. However, before Ministry Executioner could carry out the execution, Pagpig was saved by Harry and Hermione with the help of Hermione's Time Turner, and then it came to be owned by Sirius Black. In 1994, Lucius attended the Quidditch World Cup with his family, sitting in the luxury box of Minister of Magic Corlinius Fudge. Though he was disgusted that Arthur Weasley was there in the top box with his children along with Harry and Hermione, Lucius and Arthur restrained themselves due to being in Fudge's presence. In the aftermath of the cup, Malfoy and some other former Death Eaters were involved in the torture and humiliation of the Muggle sit manager of the stadium and his family. Though he was not known at the time to the public and officials, he fled when the Dark Mark was launched into the sky. When Lord Voldemort rose again in the summer of 1995, Malfoy returned to him on his summons, claiming that he had done everything he could all along to find Voldemort and help him rise again. Voldemort believed that Malfoy had not truly get away with his old ways, but questioned his loyalties, because Malfoy had fled the Dark Mark at the World Cup. Even though Harry witnessed Malfoy's declaration of loyalties to Voldemort, almost nobody in the Ministry believed him, and Malfoy continued maintaining strong ties to very high places in the Ministry. In 1995, Malfoy appeared doing shady dealings with Corlinius Fudge in the Department of Mysteries. Just before Harry's trial, it was implied that Malfoy was giving money to the Ministry. Malfoy's meeting with Fudge were also used as excuses to place the Imperius curse on Ministry officials such as Broderick Bode, an Order of Phoenix member, Sargis Bodmore, on Voldemort's orders. This curse was placed in order to obtain Sibyl Trelawney's first prophecy. However, these attempts were short-lived as Bode failed to obtain the prophecy, therefore causing Voldemort to murder him, and Bodmore was arrested for attempting to break into the Hall of Prophecies. Lucius also gave his support to create the post of Hogwarts High Inquisitor for Dolores Umbridge to inspect the teacher's performance. During an interview about this post, he used this to discredit Dumbledore under the pretense of caring for the future of the school and fearing Dumbledore's wrong decisions. After the failure of his previous attempt to obtain the prophecy, Voldemort successfully attempted to get Harry to the Hall of Prophecies by planting a vision of his godfather being tortured in his mind. Malfoy, along with Bellatrix and fellow Death Eaters, were involved in the Battle of the Department of Mysteries when they were sent to obtain the prophecy from Harry's hand. However, Harry and the five friends who occupied him, all Dumbledore Army members, managed to hold off the Death Eaters until several members of Order of Phoenix arrived. Lucius' mission to retrieve the prophecy ultimately failed. Longbottom, under the influence of a steep dance curse from Antonio Dolohov, accidentally broke the prophecy. Lucius was seen by Ministry officials called by Albus Dumbledore to the scene with the evidence that pointed to his identity as a Death Eater. Lucius was promptly sent to Azkaban prison, as was the rest of the Death Eater squad. The only exception was Bellatrix Lestrange, who escaped with Voldemort. After the event in the Department of Mysteries, Voldemort mainly blamed Lucius for this failure, as Lucius was the head of Voldemort's small task force. Lucius Malfoy's failure at the Department of Mysteries, combined with his accidentally destroying the part of Voldemort's soul contained within the Diary of Tom Riddle, result in his loss of any standing with the Dark Lord. Some believe that it was safer in Azkaban than being free. In the summer of 1997, nearly a year after being imprisoned, Lucius and all the other Death Eaters escaped Azkaban prison with the help of Voldemort, who never bothered to get him out after all that time. It was mentioned that Lucius may have been secretly glad to have been kept in Azkaban, as he was away from Voldemort and his terrible wrath. Voldemort was convinced to do so by Draco Malfoy's success in the plot to assassinate Albus Dumbledore. In actuality, this was a further attempt to punish Lucius, as Voldemort really didn't think that Draco would succeed in this mission, and would dispose of Draco and possibly the other Malfoys as well. However, because Draco didn't kill Dumbledore himself, the Malfoys was no longer held in high regard by the Dark Lord, who made their home as a base of operation, and his favor fell on Bellatrix Lestrange and Severus Snape since he killed Dumbledore. Voldemort openly mocked the family at a Death Eater meeting in the summer of 1987, and taking Lucius went. In short, Lucius had become reduced to nothing more than a servant. The Malfoys were desperate for a chance to be forgiven, and thus were excited when a group of Snatchers led by Fenrir Greyback brought Harry Potter and his friends to the Marrow in the spring of 1988. Lucius pressed his son to identify Harry and identified Ron Weasley as one of Arthur Weasley's sons. However, Draco denied knowing who Harry was. He then argued with Bellatrix about who would be the one to call Voldemort with the Dark Marks, but they held off when Bellatrix noticed Gryffindor's sword, which she had believed to be in her Gringotts vault, among their possessions. After that, Bellatrix tortured Hermione Granger for information about the sword with the Cruciatus curse, while the others were taken to the cellar downstairs. After Hermione lied about the sword being a copy, and Grey Fawkes went along with her story, Bellatrix was about to call Voldemort, but Dobby the Malfoy's former house elf came to the rescue of the prisoners. Harry and Ron ran back upstairs, and the former stunned Lucius and Greyback. After their escape, the Malfoys and Bellatrix were severely banished by Voldemort and were confined to the manor. By the time of the Battle of Hogwarts, Lucius showed that he was more concerned with his son's safety than Voldemort's cause, begging to be permitted to find him when the fighting began. "My lord, please, my son. If your son is dead, Lucius, it's not my fault. He did not come and join me like the rest of Slytherins." Narcissa lied directly to Voldemort for Harry's sake when he informed her that Draco was still alive, and she and Lucius ran through the court, not even attempted to fight, screaming for their son. Lucius was present in for Harry Potter's final defeat of Lord Voldemort. Following Voldemort's defeat, Lucius, Narcissa and Draco sat in the Great Hall during the celebrations, looking unsure that he belonged there. Lucius and Draco's crimes were forgiven due to their abandonment of Voldemort and his cause, and Narcissa's lie to the Dark Lord that saved Harry Potter's life in the Forbidden Forest in the Battle of Hogwarts. None of them served time in Azkaban due to the evidence he provided against fellow Death Eaters, and his hope to ensure the capture of many Voldemort's followers who had fled into hiding. Lucius would eventually gain a grandson, Scorpius Malfoy, after Draco married Astoria Greengrass. Despite his cold and ruthless nature, Lucius was one of the only Death Eater in Voldemort's inner circle who was capable of feeling love. Lucius cared deeply about his family, especially Narcissa and Draco. In the end, his love for his family drove him to abandon Voldemort and be with his family.